Hey everyone, today I'm in Yucaipa and we're going to take a look at Phil's amazing orchard. Yay! Hey everyone, Anthony here. Welcome to my adventure vlog, another episode. And today I'm at a very special place, joined by Brendan and Phil and Matt.
Yay!
And today we are looking at, what do you call this, Phil?
This is the orchard, the Vecchio Orchard.
The Vecchio Orchard.
Yeah. As heard on, if you've heard, talk about
Radio,
Radio Brendoman
on, a lot on Pillagecast.
I've talked about it, yep.
Yeah, I remember those episodes. Those always fascinated me, but they annoyed Josh, the other co-host.
Yep, that was the
special
gate. Yeah, they would always get mad. kind of our bit. So we started out in the front. There's a couple. There's a nectarine tree.
You're eating one right now.
Yeah, it's very tasty. Very, very sweet.
Very good.
Tastes excellent.
You'll probably see a lot of weeds poking up. We just got back from vacation. There's some stuff. This year is our neighbor's tree, but we let it hang over because there's lots of good plums on it when they're in season. But there, we already ate those. We got a nice lilac. Oh, this one's cool. This is actually a lemon sage. Here.
Phil loves.
Take this. Just smell that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Smells like lemon. Yeah.
Smells like lemon, right? That's pretty cool. We have several different spices and herbs that grow around as well.
Here's the playhouse.
Okay, so over here, we got these are fig trees. You gotta try a fig.
Figs? Figs like exist outside of a Newton?
Absolutely.
Oh, that's look at this, Phil.
What?
Right here.
What?
Oh, what yeah, that's like a June bug or whatever.
June
going
bug.
To town on. Gross.
Ew.
Whoa. Like whoa. Ah! Okay, oh that freaked us out a little bit. A little tiny flying bug scared us four men. Us four men were scared by a bug.
Okay, here we go.
Well, those things bite, dude.
They do. They just bite fruit.
They bite people.
They hurt.
They hurt.
Okay, here's a good one for Anthony right here. So I just picked a fig off. I'm going to pop it open so you can see. That's what it looks like inside.
It's like an alien.
Kind of does. And you get to eat that. Now you can eat. Oh, here.
Hold on. Okay.
Here, you got to hand it. Now you can eat the skin if you want to. You can just eat the stuff out of the inside. Want me to hold
the skin? No, I can do this.
You got it? Okay. What do you think?
Ah, tasty.
Yeah, it's really sweet, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did Matthew, Brendo, you guys need a...
Oh, I'm on a fig.
No.
Well, Matthew, you know how to get them. So here's a good one right there.
No fig.
Fig. Yum.
I always pop them open because, as you noticed, we don't use... It's all organic here in the Vecchio Orchard, of course. So, you know, we get bugs sometimes.
No GMOs.
That's right. So you got to pop them open and make sure there's no ants in there because the ants like these things. This over here is an almond tree. You can see kind of the remnants of some almonds left over on here.
What's the normal season for almonds?
They should have been ripening or just finishing up. We do have some bug issues on this one. The ones that are left were gotten. Ooh, is that one any good?
No.
Okay, but come show. You can see what it looks like, though. This is what it should look like.
It looks like a scallop.
Yeah, look inside. And then pop that little brown skin open in there. And you'll see.
That's the almond.
But see, you can see the gunk on there. That means a bug got to it. But just peel it open, you can see the
larvae.
Actually, almond. Yeah, they plant their eggs in there. That one looks kind of gross.
But there's an almond.
You can see it looks just like you'd have in a jar there.
I need to wash my hands.
Okay, I've never actually seen one fresh off a tree.
That's what it looks like, except that one's bad.
There you go. That's an adventure right here.
All right.
So back this way.
We'll cruise around this way.
Wait, I need a hose.
Well, there's a hose over here. Perfect.
The swing set of doom.
There's a swing set of doom.
That looks kind of creepy.
Notice it's not anchored into the ground, which is why it's the swing set of doom.
It's all built except for...
Phil will demonstrate. So as his kids get bigger, it becomes more of a risk.
I'm going to have to mount it there, definitely.
But, so it's not yet complete. Mark Bolton, just so you're...
Still not there.
Sorry.
Have you ever seen it like start swinging and there's like no wind?
No. It's not. It's pretty sturdy. I mean, you have to kind of...
No, ghosts.
Oh, the ghosts. Yeah, true.
Orchard ghosts?
Orchard ghosts.
You have to be careful about orchard ghosts.
This is another fig tree, and then a third fig tree here. So we got... And they're actually slightly different varieties. You don't have to eat them all. Depends on how much you like figs.
I'm gonna win that or that swing set of doom contest, by the way.
This one, oh, you are. These are persimmons here. Oh, we got some starting to come in, you can see.
Don't eat persimmons.
Well, they're not ripe right now, but you can see this guy here.
What do you do with them, Phil?
I give them away as much as possible. I usually eat about one a year. They're very, very, very sweet. They have the consistency of like a snot booger kind of thing.
Got sucked into your iPhone, and that's why you have a new phone.
That's why I had to get a new phone, because I left the persimmon in my pocket and it squished around on my phone. I forgot it was in there.
Oh boy.
So yeah, that was bad. So more fig, and then down this little aisle here, there's an apple tree right there. We actually might have some apples. You could try an apple if you want an apple.
What kind of apple?
Just little like green apples.
How do you like them apples?
They're okay. Well, these ones definitely, I did some research this year and I know how to handle the bugs on this one better, but I have to buy traps, but it's too late in the season.
Now, is it the same type of pest that eat apples, June bugs, or do you get like worms?
No, they're actually worms. They're called they're moths, but it's like they're caterpillar, they're worm, right? And so they lay, you can see in some of these here, yep, here you go. So they kind of burrow in. You see the little like brown spot there, and you can actually just cut away. It just kind of makes a brown spot in there. And so we usually will make applesauce with them because the fruit itself is fine except for the little part they burrowed in on. But they have these little traps. You just kind of hang them in the branches, and then it attracts them, and they plant their worms there instead. So I got to get those for next year.
Okay.
Yeah. And we got another nectarine tree right here that we had out in front, but it's almost all empty. And this is our peach tree. I don't know, this one might be good. No, it's not quite there yet. We had a very small run of peaches this year because of the drought.
Oh,
everything's
right.
Very dry, so. But the cool part about this tree.
You have to conserve water in California.
Yeah. So, I mean, I've been watering it, but, you know, we had to. And just
wait, tell me that story about the time that you flooded your orchard, because that's fascinating.
I can show you back over there where it actually was. It was with this hose, but it was over there.
Phil left the hose on for his whole vacation.
This is before we were in the major drought, but I might or might not have accidentally left a hose on.
How much was your water bill?
For it was almost $400.
Whoa, $400 worth of water.
And so the good thing is after that, and now in the current, you know, climate, we've able to cut our water down, not just from that, but from our regular usage, about 75%. So we got a drip system that goes through the whole yard and takes care of the watering just in those specific spots.
Also, the
spots.
Regulations aren't. Don't apply if you make if you're raising your own food that you eat.
Right.
I did not know that.
How to use more didn't water, that. But I still do my best to to conserve as much as possible. So. The cool thing about this tree, so this is peach here and this is nectarine, but if you look together, they come from the same thing. They're grafted together, so it's the same tree that produces the different types of fruit.
So then, do you have a special name for that tree?
I've never really named them. I just know the fruit that's on them, I guess. I don't know. This is another fig tree, different variety. This is actually my favorite one. This one's the sweetest, but it ripens a little later. There's another June bug.
Ugh, I hate June bugs like so much. They remind me of Missouri too much.
This is a plum. The plums are gone at this point.
This is a fairly large orchard a family.
It still keeps going. We're only like halfway through.
Phil could like. If you had the resources, you could turn this into like a farmer's market type.
It definitely could be. Okay, so
that takes
there,
a lot of.
This is another little plum that's growing up. Apricot here and an apricot there. This is our. I've been experimenting with doing vegetable garden
with the help of Matthew.
With the help of Matthew, yes. And I had some good stuff here, and the gopher got to this little patch here.
Oh man, because you had some. You were starting to get some watermelons.
I had watermelons growing on it, and you can see like they dug it up here, and we had. Cucumbers and some other things, but I do have a few things that are still growing in. So this here, we got some strawberries. You can see that's going. There's actually, I don't know if they're going to make it, but they're coming in there. Got a little tomato plant. Look at this. There's a tomato on there.
Oh, yeah.
See that there?
Is that a cherry tomato?
Yeah, they're like little cherry tomatoes. So that's almost ready to go. And that's a pepper plant. And you can see the flowers on there. They're like little Tabasco peppers. That's pretty cool.
Can you make Tabasco sauce? Mm.
If you come back around here, well, you can.
Do you have your red stick to see if they're red, the right color?
No,
you know
I
they do that.
I know, I do.
That's
but
how they know.
What I have used them for is I cut them up, I cut them off and chop them up and dry them. Mm-hmm. And you know like the little red peppers you put on pizza?
Yeah.
It's those, so I make my own of those.
Yeah. When I went to New Orleans, I traveled the 2 hours outside New Orleans to the island where the Tabasco factory is and the farms and everything. and they that's what they do. They take a they have a red stick, and it's the color of the pepper that's supposed to be, and that's how they tell if it's ready to pick. Yeah. Is they hold the, stick up.
Oh, okay.
There's actually a Popeyes commercial where they show the stick, but that's real.
The Tabasco.
Yeah, and the Tabasco, and then I've had like fresh Tabasco sauce, and then they actually had Tabasco ice cream.
Whoa!
It was Tabasco really good.
I've
it was.
Never heard of that.
I mean, well, it was like soft serve.
Wow.
And it was like spicy, but it was also like it was. You would have loved it.
Maybe so.
It was really good. That was also where I ate like alligator and some other weird stuff.
Alligators.
This
nice.
Is this is our little orange tree. When we moved here, this thing was like I thought it was dead, and I just started watering
it. So oranges start off green.
So yeah, they start off green. These are like the ones for next year.
Like, that looks like a lime.
Yeah. I'll show you the limes though. They have a different shape to them too.
Smell something orange.
Yeah, something orange. Something
what kind of orange is it?
These are they're kind of like a mandarin orange. They're sweeter.
It's an orange.
Some of them are still good. We got the tail end of them on here. I mean, if you want one, I can find one. I don't know how many fruits you want to eat. I'll this one will be good here. Yeah, that's good still. All right, we'll pop
and then
it
you
open
have
here.
The trampoline that's been assaulted by the cat.
Yeah, this is the trampoline the cats keep getting too.
Oh wow, look at that hole in the back.
I know.
There.
I got. We're gonna have to get a new thing
that's...
there. So we have this orange. The other orange is a navel orange. This one is it's like I can't remember the name of it, but they're a little sweeter. They're called like a sweet orange or something. Then this big tree behind us here is walnut.
Are those coming
and
in?
They are. They're not quite ripe yet though. You can kind of look at Matthew's got a demonstration one there.
Here we go, demonstration walnut.
You can see they grow inside these green things and then they dry out, and if you look inside there, when they're actually ready to go, they turn black and it looks like a walnut. You can kind of see on this side right there, like see, it's like on the tip there.
Fascinating.
Walnut. Like a walnut. That's what they grow into. Yeah. It's a lot of like the almonds, same kind of thing.
But this is the, that's what they look like.
Okay. I peeled your orange for you if you want. These ones have
Thanks,
seeds,
Phil.
So beware, you know, it's walnut.
I have a orange from the Vecchio Orchard.
Mm-hmm, those are good.
Vecchio oranges.
Mmm. Fantastic. Mm-hmm. Very delicious.
Yeah, I've been fighting the gophers. I got to replant. I got a couple traps that I yanked out, and I got to bury again. This is one of them that
gopher spot.
Did not successfully. This is a gopher trap here. So, you see, I don't want to touch it with my hands because it's gross, but it's kind of like a mouse trap. You push this thing down, and then it pops up on them, and you bury it into the ground
so
they think it's part of their tunnel, and they climb in and get them.
So what do you do with the gophers when you catch it?
You have to get to it before the cats eat it.
Well, yeah. Sometimes the cats just take care of the problem. And
but often they leave their stuff.
Sometimes they'll leave little
the
bits
place.
Of it and stuff, and I just throw them in the trash.
Have your kids
Gross.
Been traumatized?
Not yet. They're aware, because here's the thing. They're more upset that the gophers keep getting the plants. So they're
yes.
okay with me clearing out. Because
they
were like so excited for watermelon.
Sticks to protect plants.
Yes, yes.
From the gophers.
So.
Have you ever thought of having a gopher for dinner?
Oh, no. Ugh. There's just little rodents. They're
that's like eating
gross.
A mouse.
Yeah. I mean, I suppose...
Like, who knows what kind of stuff you would get from eating...
Yeah. There's another...
They're definitely disease carriers.
Definitely.
Lynn, here's a...
Okay, then tip for everyone, do not eat gophers. They might have diseases,
yeah,
maybe...
I would not recommend it. Here's the other one I just pulled out here that I gotta do. Now, this over here is interesting. This is our compost pile here. This whole little cement, it was a foundation probably for a shed at some point, but I take all this stuff and pile it in here, and then when I plant new stuff, you know, I dig it up out of here, I gotta turn it again. Right now you can see stuff grows out and then I turn it over.
So you use that to grow?
So I use it to grow new stuff. Yeah.
Hmm, interesting.
This year the plum tree, this one had the last of the plums.
Yeah,
it's
we
a different
a
variety.
The other.
I have a feeling though they might be
I think they're
gone at this point. Let's see if I can spot any. Do you see any, Matt?
I'm looking.
I don't see any.
See, like, one little tiny one that looks bad.
I think
bad.
Derek and I had, like, one of the
I think
last.
You guys might have had the last ones of the season. The cool thing about this orchard, and I didn't plant everything. I planted some new stuff, but whoever planted it before we moved here, they planted so there's always something in season at every time during the year. So no matter when you come, there is a fruit or something that's ready to eat.
How old do you think this orchard might be? Maybe a decade old? Maybe 20 years?
Oh, it's definitely more than that. I mean, we've lived here for 5 years. The house was built in the 60s, like I think 63.
It feels 60s.
And I'm pretty 60s. Sure it's at least... Now, before that, though, they were... we're pretty sure it was olive groves. Because this tree here, and this one, and there's a whole line of them planted in a line there, are all olive trees.
But you can't really do anything.
But you have to cure them. You can't eat them off the tree. They're growing in right now.
Yeah, and I'm going to cure them this year. Yeah. I really am.
That's one of Matthew's projects.
The baby ones.
He's bent on...
But like he's tried olive... before, and then they've gotten moldy.
Well, because you have to get a press, and like that's...
Well, no, that's olive oil.
Oh.
But Dave and I think we might have found one that's...
Yeah, that's
but just curing the olives, what's the process? I mean...
Well, there's a bunch of different ways. You either have to use lye...
Yeah, it gets kind of scary.
Or you have to have like salt water that you change out every single day.
So you like change them out, and so it's you
know, you can dry pack them, but then they in salt, and that gives them a really bitter. No,
so it's not easy to use them. We've tried a number of times,
but this year, eventually, this year we're gonna have olives.
It's a nice like kind of tree line here. So I'm pretty sure there used to be like a whole olive orchard here.
Well, plus if you look at this whole property area, there's like a big lot of space.
Yeah, and they're definitely planted in a straight row. So I bet you it just kept carrying on over that way. These are the apricots. Those were in season a little while ago. Those are delicious.
It's funny, there's olives on the street. I bet you that's the same row continuing out.
Yeah, yeah, I'm telling you, I think this whole area was all olives. You've never had an apricot fresh off the tree. It is nothing like what you've had in
the thing in the world.
You can't, because the problem is apricots have a very, very short shelf life once they're ripe. So if you pick them and then they bring them to the store, they're only good for a couple days. So what they do in the store is they have to pick them real early before they're really ripe, so they don't taste right.
Didn't know that.
Yeah, so I'm telling you, it's a completely different experience. So that's the outer orchard, but you have one more little inner area here.
Oh, a secret orchard.
Well, what's funny, when you come out of the house, this is like the backyard, and then that's the secret orchard, but we did it backwards. So that's okay. When we came here, when we were looking at the house, we thought this whole yard was it, just this inner
just
yard.
This yard.
And then we're like, so who owns that? And they're like, oh, that's part of the property too. And we're like, what?
What?
Yes. Like the whole big, that whole place is
it's all overgrown.
Now, we're not 100% sure about this, because we just discovered recently. Dad says he's not 100% sure, but
you gotta look at the flowers.
I think these are bay leaves, which you use in like Italian cooking spaghetti sauce.
They smell
and
like it.
And Phil is Italian, so.
That's right, Vecchio.
I'm almost positive.
Can you want to smell it? Do you know bay leaf at all?
I have no idea.
Like in pasta sauce?
Well, anyway, they put them
smell,
in pasta
it does
sauce.
Smell something pasta related.
I'm pretty or sure like old almost bay everything seasoning. They planted here is something produces something. This tree here is another apricot here.
Look at this thing.
And over here, these are two that I planted. This is a lime tree. And it's actually, we just planted it a couple years ago. And look at this, we got like tons of limes.
Limes grow well in Yucaipa, Phil?
Yeah. Honestly, it's very easy to grow stuff in Yucaipa. It's very fertile ground. And I am not a particularly like talented grower of things. But you can't kill stuff out here if you want to. So... you can see the shape of them looks more like a lime, even though the oranges are green. They were like round. It's more of like that classic lime shape. So.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So, yeah. And then this one over here, this little guy is a lemon tree. And lemon it hasn't quite made lemons yet, although, I don't know, we've got some buds on here now, so it's possible
so
we can get
this,
a couple.
If it's not growing lemons, I guess it might be a lemon, huh?
That was a total Phil joke. I like it.
Phil is great at puns.
Then this one, what is this one again?
Phil is a dad.
That's oregano.
But this is oregano?
He was a dad. He was the master of the dad joke. Although, I don't know,
yeah,
did you
yeah.
see that Stephen
that
King
sage?
Dad joke?
Sage.
I did see that.
What do we got here?
We got sage?
Oregano? Rosemary.
Rosemary. It's rosemary.
You
see the Stephen King
can smell that?
Dad joke there?
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Rosemary.
Yep.
Okay. This is the other orange tree. You can see it's already loaded for next year. These are navel oranges.
So oranges are green when they're not ripe, huh?
Yep. Yeah, they start out like that. And then they're like winter fruit, so around Christmas and stuff, that's when we'll get these or all be ready to go.
Oh, I didn't know that oranges grow in the winter. I usually think of them like California, sunshine, spring, summer.
Right. Well, and sometimes, depending on how you plant them and the type of fruit, sometimes you can get multiple crops throughout the year out of them.
I've noticed your
but
dad.
But typically it's the winter. At least the ones that I have
year.
Are.
Oh my God.
The figs do that too. They'll have like multiple seasons. This is a big old weed here that I
like your dad graduated to the next level.
Rose plant doesn't. You can technically eat rose hips though. So like
I
the little.
They were poison.
No, it makes a good jelly.
They're good. Like you can just eat the petals.
I've seen like a rose petal soda or something like that.
Like this right here. Look. This little like base of the flower here. That's the rose hip. And you can, they make like tea out of it and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't actually used it personally, but it's there. Then we got, what is this one, Matthew? I can never remember
that
what
one,
the...
let me smell it.
You got the Vecchio Orchard Roller Coaster.
That's the oregano.
Yeah.
This is oregano.
There's a track, and like there you sit on that if you're of size.
Oh, yeah. He Luke does that thing flying.
Is there a height limit?
Well, if you can fit
if
on
you
that.
You can fit on that, yes. Must be able to fit on this to ride.
Are these more nectarines?
Yeah, these are more nectarines. As you can see, they're like falling off the tree. So we can have more if you want. Oregano down there. Then you got nectarine, and then one last apricot tree over here. And that brings you back to the front of the house. On the other side. And that is the orchard.
Where did you learn how to be an orchard farmer, Phil?
Well, it's
to go
funny.
To orchard supply I did not, hardware, which they don't have out here.
Yeah, no, they have them like in Pasadena. Okay. Yeah.
Because it's specifically orchard supply. Yeah.
Actually, though, my grandpa, like I grew up and he has a yard. I don't know. It's probably about the same size.
It's pretty,
you say, Matt?
It's about this
about the same size.
And he's got peaches. Oranges, tangerines, avocados, figs.
Avocados.
Yeah, avocados are fantastic. Well,
also, they used to dump up. They give Phil so much fruit that Phil actually, when we were in college, had a fruit fly outbreak in his dorm room.
Oh, yeah, because I would just bring boxes of
and
fruit.
And we would just sit there. We couldn't keep up fast enough. Eventually, there'd just be fruit flies
and then we'd have
everywhere
to
in Phil's dorm room.
But so just kind of growing up watching him, and then my dad planted a bunch of fruit trees in our house, even though in Big Bear it doesn't grow as well because of the mountain.
Apples and pears.
Plus, we have Oak Glen right up here, which is like the apple.
Yeah.
You got to come up and go to Oak Glen sometime. Yeah, that's like true. Where you can go on orchard.
That could be another episode.
Yeah, another episode. Because
they have full on orchard apple picking and cider and all that stuff.
So, I mean, when we saw this property and saw the fruit trees, I was sold. Janelle's like, are you sure you want to do that? Seems like a lot of work. And I'm like, I grew up in this. This is one thing Phil will work at.
Yeah.
It's tough. I mean,
especially when it's like, I don't know if you guys can tell, but we're all sweating.
It's so hot. Yeah.
It's not even that hot. This is not a hot Yucaipa day.
No, but that's
like,
why like
it gets into like the 100 degrees.
In the summer, the weeds get a little taller.
That's
like,
why we haven't been walking. I was just telling Anthony, like, because Gates and I went on a big old hike up in the mountains, but I'm like, I will not do that.
No, you guys would die.
We would die.
Not today. Maybe in the fall.
But fall is when then I got to clean up everything. Yeah.
So the next time you come, we should go to Oak Glen and we should go on some hikes. Because there's a lot of awesome hikes. Because he was asking me what we do out here for fun. I was like, oh, there's tons of hikes just during the summer.
You can't do it right now.
We've also got the regional park.
Yeah.
Which has water slides, fishing. It's a lot of outdoors stuff out here.
You guys can look forward to a lot of episodes coming up in the future about the wonders of Yucaipa and nature.
Yes, indeed. Absolutely.
Okay, well, not only are you an expert orchard farmer, but Brendan and Phil, you also do a podcast, is that right?
Yes.
That's right, yes. Radio Brendo.
RadioBrendo.com. We put up episodes every week. We're getting ready to make some records.
Whoa.
We also have a web comic, if you want to check that out.
Yeah.
BraxComics.com. And, BenviewNetwork.com. For our whole network of podcasts. That's
BraxComics.com.
And then,
Whoa, I got my own
I guess
net.
We got
Titles
a plug,
here.
Since there's also the other Phil's better half, Janelle, has That's her true. Own MrsVecchio.com if you are a teacher.
That's right. Yeah, she got
And Matthew's website, it is MattandDave.com.
Dave and Matt and Dave. Dave and Matt? Oh my gosh.
You don't even know your own website.
DaveandMatt.com. Matt and Dave.
One of those.
And what's that about?
You can see some of the projects that he's working
on. Yeah. Like we were posting about the olive oil.
Yeah,
presses.
The olive oil press. They do all kinds of like DIY projects and other stuff and post about how they make that stuff.
I think it's
stuff.
Dave and Matt because I think Matt and Dave was taken.
Yeah, DaveandMatt.com.
There you
yeah,
go.
Yeah, and then Dave you and can Matt. See Matt Dave. Dave bought an arcade cabinet.
Yeah,
so you can see his. He's trying
stuff.
To restore that. So they do a lot of cool DIY projects. Yeah. Matthew was showing some of his different gardening techniques. DreamHost.com. Use the code RadioBrendoMan to save 50% off your web hosting. No, $50 off.
Yeah.
Which could even be a bigger deal.
Could be.
That is an excellent deal.
All right.
So, yeah. There you go.
Thanks for having us on your show.
Oh, well, thank you, guys. Thanks for having me. Okay, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Anthony's Adventure Vlog. And you can also follow me on Twitter at Anthony the Giant. You guys have Twitter too?
At Brendoman for both of us.
Yeah, that's my appeal.
Just if it's for Phil, just say Phil.
Okay, thanks for watching, guys. Until next time.
Yeah.